फ्रेंड्स सब्सक्राइब कीजिए वाईफाई स्टडी चैनल को और बेल आइकन को दबाइए डेली वोकैब वीडियो सबसे पहले देखने के लिए। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू wifistudy.com, वन स्टॉप डेस्टिनेशन फॉर ऑल कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम प्रेजेंट्स करंट अफेयर 2017 मार्च सेकंड वीक इन इंग्लिश। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू प्रोवाइड यू द करंट अफेयर सेक्शन ऑफ द सेकंड वीक ऑफ मार्च इन इंग्लिश। ओके, इन आर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी अपलोडेड इन हिंदी, राइट नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू प्रोवाइड इन इंग्लिश। So friends, this page is very important for you. If you have any problem in the vocab, not able to score good marks in a vocab, you can purchase our pen drive course in which you will get 60 videos of 3000 words in which you will get a very short trick by which you will easily able to remember all the vocabs. Apart from it, you will get a synonyms, example, images, and if you access why vocab 24 app, you will get in 497 rupees, and if you want an 8GB pen drive, you will get in 999, and if you have any query, then you can use this number. And friends, if you are want to prepare from the application mode, then you can download our Vocab 24 app. This is the one of the best app you will ever see on Google Play Store. And in this, you will get 10 new words from the Hindu editorial daily. Okay, so friends, and if you like this video, please subscribe us so that we can provide you more videos for the upcoming exam. So friends, let's see the international question first. After that, we are going to cover the national, then sports, trade and banking, economy, appointments, everything we are going to cover in this video. So let's see the international question first. What is the theme of International Women's Day 2017? Very important question, friends, because you always need to remember International Women's Day and the National Women's Day. All these dates are very important for you and the themes are also very important for you. Okay, so first of all, we are going to see the entire news. After that, we will pick up the answer. Okay, so 8th March, International Women's Day. And this day is an event held around the world to commemorate the struggle for the women's rights. And this year, theme is Be Bold for Change. Okay, so this is the theme that you need to remember, and your answer is A. Be Bold for Change is the theme for International Women's Day 2017. And friends, you also need to remember National Women's Day also. Okay, this day, the National Women's Day is observed on 13 February, and this is the birth date of India's first woman governor, that is Sarojini Naidu. And she is also known as the Nightingale of India, and she is the first governor of any Indian state, and she is also the first Indian woman to become INC president. Okay, so these are the important things that you need to remember. 13 Feb is observed as National Women's Day, and 8th March is observed as International Women's Day. Okay, so these are the things that you need to remember. What is the name of the military exercise between India and Nepal? Okay, so let's see the news first. Indo-Nepal joint military exercise Surya Kiran 11 begins. So Surya Kiran is the name of the military exercise which is between the India and Nepal. Okay, and it began in Uttarakhand. Okay, it began in Uttarakhand. So you need to also remember the place where it was held, and it was held in Uttarakhand. And Surya Kiran is the name of this joint military exercise. Okay, and few other information apart from this is Nepal capital is the Kathmandu, currency is rupee, president is the Bindya Devi Bhandari, and prime minister is the Pushpa Kamal Dayal. So these are the another important information that you need to remember, and your answer is Surya Kiran. Okay, there are few other important Indian military joint military exercises also. Okay, that you need to remember, that is like Mitra Shakti is between India and Sri Lanka. There another one like Hand in Hand, there is another military exercise like Hand in Hand, it is between India and China. Exercise Shakti is between India and France. Okay, Nomadic Elephant, it is between India and Mongolia. Yudh Abhyas is between India and USA, and Prabal Dostak is between India and Kazakhstan. So these are the other important military exercises that you need to remember apart from the Surya Kiran. Which country has the highest bribery rate in the Asia Pacific region? Okay, so one of the most corruption begins from this bribery. Okay, so which country has the highest bribery rate in the Asia Pacific region? So let's see the news. India has highest incidence of bribery in Asia Pacific, one of our survey told us. Okay, over 900 million people are one in four across the 16 nations in the Asia Pacific region paid a bribe in the past year when trying to assist basic services like education or healthcare. Okay, so in the sectors like education and healthcare, which are the basic sectors, people need to give the bribery to take this basic services also, and India has the highest incidence of bribery in Asia. So this is the worst news for an Indian. Okay, India was closely followed by Vietnam, then Thailand, Cambodia, Pakistan, Myanmar, and this survey was released by Transparency International. Aim of this organization is to Okay, it is a non-profit purpose is to take action to combat corruption and to prevent criminal activities arising from corruption. So there are many criminal activities which arises from the corruption and they want to tackle it. Okay, this is the aim of the Transparency International. Its headquarters is in Berlin, Germany. It was founded in 1993 and right now the chairperson is Jos Yugas and he's from Peru. Okay, so your answer is India. India has the highest bribery rate in Asia Pacific region. Which country's constitutional court did vote unanimously to remove the country's president Park Geun-hye from office? Okay, so which country's constitutional court did vote unanimously to remove the country's president Park Geun-hye from office? So let's see the news. South Korean constitutional court voted unanimously to remove the country's president, that is Park Geun-hye, from office. So your answer is South Korea. Okay, so South Korean constitutional court ordered to remove the country's president, that is Park Geun-hye. And with the impeachment, Park became the first South Korean president to be removed from office. That you need to remember also. At present, Prime Minister Han Kyo-an is serving as the acting president of the country. Okay, so you need to remember this name. This question might be coming in your upcoming exam. Where has been the mega culture festival India by Nile started? So there was a festival which was held, okay, named India by the Nile. So let's see the news. The mega cultural festival India by the Nile got off to a cultural start at the foot of the pyramids with a craft mela showcasing joint handicraft exhibition of India and Egypt. Okay, the Embassy of India in Cairo in collaboration with the Teamwork Art presented craft mela as a part of the IBN 2017 cultural festival. So this festival was started in Egypt and the capital of Egypt is Cairo. Okay, and you need to remember some other thing about the Nile also. Okay, the total length of the Nile river is 6853 kilometers, and 11 countries of the Africa are on this shore of this Nile river, and there are two primary and secondary, there are one primary and one secondary source of the Nile also. The primary source is the White Nile and the secondary source is the Blue Nile. Okay, this Nile started from the Ethiopia and the mouth of this river is in Egypt, and it is a north flowing river in the northeastern African countries. So this is another important that you need to remember about the Nile. And India by Nile festival started in Egypt. Which country will conduct its first census after 19 years? So there is one neighboring country of ours which conducted its first census after 19 years. So let's see the news. Pakistan is set to conduct its first national census in 19 years with the assistance of over 2 lakh troops. Okay, so Pakistan is the country which set to conduct its first census in 19 years. So your answer is Pakistan. C is your answer. Which country will observe 25th March as Genocide Day? So one of our neighboring country observed 25th March as a Genocide Day. So let's see the news. Pakistan declares 25th March as Genocide Day. Genocide Day because of the Pakistani army. Okay, there was a problem in the 1970-71 in the Bangladesh and the Pakistan, and the Bangladesh wanted freedom from the Pakistan. Okay, it was the East Pakistan, and they wanted freedom, and India helped them to become free. At that time, Indira Gandhi was the Prime Minister of our nation, and that war took place on 3rd December 1971 to 16th December 1971. And the Lieutenant General at that time of the Pakistan was A.A.K. Niazi. He was the commander of the Pakistan command, and he signs the instrument of surrender at that time. And the Lieutenant General of Indian command was Jagdish Singh at that time, Jagdish Singh Arora. And at that time the Chief of the Army Staff was Manekshaw and the Defense Minister was Jagjivan Ram. So these are another important information that you need to remember. So Bangladesh adopted a resolution declaring 25th March as a Genocide Day in remembrance of the atrocities carried out by the Pakistani army in the night of the 25th March 1971. Okay, so your answer is Bangladesh. Bangladesh declared 25th March as a Genocide Day. Which is the world best city to live in? So Vienna is the world best, nicest city to live in, Baghdad the worst. Another important question. Vienna, Austria, grand capital on the Danube River, has topped consulting firm Mercer Light list of cities offering the highest quality of life for the 8th year in a row, while Baghdad is again considered the worst place to live. So Singapore was the highest ranked Asian city at 25th, while 29th place San Francisco was the United States highest entry. Top on the list is Africa was South African Durban at 87. Okay, so your answer is Vienna. Vienna is the world's best city to live in, while Baghdad is the worst city to live in. In the Asian region, you need to remember Singapore has the highest rank ओके, हाईएस्ट रैंक इन द सिटी टू लिव इन, बेस्ट सिटी टू लिव इन. सो दीज आर द अनदर इन्फॉर्मेशन यू नीड टू रिमेंबर. 2017 कॉमनवेल्थ डे वॉज ऑब्जर्व ऑन विच डेट. ओके, सो लेट्स सी द न्यूज़ फर्स्ट. कॉमनवेल्थ डे इज अ एनुअल सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ द कॉमनवेल्थ ऑफ नेशंस हेल्ड ऑन द सेकेंड मंडे इन मार्च. सो सेकेंड मंडे इन मार्च दिस ईयर इट वॉज सेलिब्रेटेड ऑन मार्च 13. द थीम ऑफ दिस ईयर इज अ पीस बिल्डिंग कॉमनवेल्थ. सो यू नीड टू रिमेंबर द डेट, द थीम, ओके, एंड द अदर इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट द कॉमनवेल्थ ऑफ नेशंस वी आर गोइंग टू सी. ओके, सो योर आंसर इज 13th March. 13th March is observed as Commonwealth Day, and the aim of the Commonwealth of Nations is that Commonwealth is an intergovernmental organization of 52 member states that were mostly former territories of the British Empire. Okay, so what is this Commonwealth of Nations? It is an organization of 52 member states that were mostly former territories of the British Empire, and its headquarters is in London, and the Queen, the head of this Commonwealth of Nations is the Queen Elizabeth II. Secretary is the Patriarch of Scotland. It was founded in 1949 and the members are 52. There are 52 members of this organization right now. Okay, so 13th March is observed as Commonwealth Day. Another important question, World Consumer Right Day is observed on which date? So let's see the news. In order to get consumer issues noticed across the world, each year World Consumer Day is observed on 15th March. Okay, so your answer is 15th March, and it is an opportunity to promote the basic rights of all the consumers, and the theme of this year is building a digital world consumer can trust. Okay, this is the theme of this year, and you also need to remember the National Consumer Day also. Okay, National Consumer Day is also important for your upcoming exam, and it is observed on 24th December. Because on this day, Consumer Protection Act 1986 was enacted. That's why we observe National Consumer Day on 24th December. Okay, 24th December, National Consumer Day. And you need to remember international date also, national date also. Now, we are going to see the national news. India will organize its first Mobile Congress in which month? So, another important question, Mobile World Congress to be held in India on September 27th. Okay, so India will organize its first Mobile Congress in September with a special focus on reaching out to the Southeast Asian markets. Recently, there are Mobile World Congress in the Barcelona and in Shanghai, and India will start in September. So your answer is D. Which city is hosting International Yoga Festival? Another important question. 2-day International Yoga Festival begins in Delhi. So it is a 2-day festival, and the city which hosted this event is the Delhi. More than 3500 participants, including eminent yoga gurus, yoga masters, scholars, policy makers, representatives from 15 to 18 countries will participate in this mega event. So your answer is New Delhi. Okay, and on 11th December, you also need to remember 2014, 21 June is observed as the International Day of Yoga. Okay, and why we chose 21 June? Because it is the longest day of the year in the Northern Hemisphere, and that's why 21 June is observed as a International Day of Yoga. So you need to remember this also. First smart tribal village inaugurated in JNK. So JNK Minister for Food, Civil Suppliers, Consumer Affairs Zulfikar Ali inaugurated the first tribal model village Habbi in the Jammu and Kashmir Rajouri district. The village has been introduced with the smart classes in the schools, better roads, electricity, water facility. Okay, so you need to remember the name of the village, Habbi. This is very important for you. Which app has been launched by CBSE to help students to find exam center? Another important question, CBSE launches exam locator app to help students to find exam center. So name of the application is exam locator. So your answer is A, exam locator. It will help student to trace the exam center. Okay. And the route map will be focused via the application also. And the headquarters of the CBSE is in New Delhi. It was founded on 3rd November 1962. And the chairperson is the Rajesh Kumar Chaturvedi. He is the chairperson of this organization, that is CBSE. Which city is hosting 11th Northeast Business Summit? So 11th Northeast Business Summit begins in New Delhi. Another important question. Okay, New Delhi. So your answer is New Delhi. It is a 2-day event initiative to facilitate investment, highlight strength of the Northeastern region and the business opportunities which Northeast has to offer. Okay, so you need to remember that there was a investment summit was also held in Northeast. Okay, first investment summit. Investment Northeast Summit. Okay, and it was held in Shillong in 2017. This is also an important question that you need to remember. It was the first investment summit in Northeast India. Okay, that was held in Shillong in 2017. You also need to remember this.
Which state has launched Pratibimba to highlight achievements? Okay, so there is a one of our state launched Pratibimba a scheme to highlight achievements. So let's see the news. Karnataka CM launches Pratibimba to project achievements. Okay, and it is a comprehensive web-based platform showcasing the government performance and achievement to the citizens, and developed as a CM dashboard. Pratibimba, which means reflection, will serve as a tool to improve the efficiency in the governance and allow citizens to track government progress. Okay, so your answer is Karnataka. Karnataka CM launches Pratibimba to highlight achievements. Where did the President of India, Pranab Mukherjee, inaugurate the 12th CII Exim Bank Conclave on India-Africa Project Partnership? Another important question. The President of India, Shri Pranab Mukherjee, inaugurated the 12th CII Exim Bank Conclave on East Africa Project Partnership in New Delhi. So your answer is New Delhi. And there are some other information that you need to remember. Okay, what is the CII? Firstly, you need to see this. What is CII? It is a Confederation of the Indian Industries. Okay, and it was started in 1895, and it is a non-governmental trade association, and the president of this CII right now is a Naushad Forbes, and it is created and environment it the it helps to create an environment conducive to the growth of the industry in the country. Okay, and what there's some other information I like to give you about the Exim also. The Exim Bank is the Export Import Bank. It was started in 1982. Its headquarters is in Mumbai. Okay, and the chairperson is the Yaduvendra Mathur, is the MD and the chairperson of this organization. Okay, recently which water jet fast attack craft has been commissioned in the Indian Navy? Another important question. So Navy commissioned INS Tilangchang at the Seabird Naval Base in Karwar. So another feather in the cap, Indian Navy added INS Tilangchang at the Seabird Naval Base in Karwar. Okay, Admiral, that is Vice Admiral Girish Luthra, Chief Commanding Flag Officer of the Western Command of the Indian Navy, commissioned INS Tilangchang, the water jet fast attack craft at the Seabird Naval. Okay, it is indigenously built vessel with patrol, and it will patrol the Karnataka sea coast and will be headquartered in the Karwar Naval Base. So your answer is A. Another important question. Mera Hunar mobile app has been launched by which state? So let's see the news. Himachal Pradesh launches mobile app, that is Mera Hunar. Okay, so HPCM, that is the Veerbhadra Singh, has launched mobile app and website Mera Hunar HP, first of its kind in the country, and is a web-based platform where the skilled, semi-skilled can apply for various jobs as per their convenience, like plumber, carpenter, mechanic, security guard, driver. Okay, so whatever talent they will have, if they can put on this platform, they will get a job. For this application has been made. So your answer is Himachal Pradesh. Which city has hosted International Vision Zero Conference? So let's say news. The International Conference on the Vision Zero and its relevance to the occupational safety and the health is being organized from 15 to 17 March 2017 at Vigyan Bhavan, New Delhi. So your answer is New Delhi. Okay, the International Vision Zero Conference was held in New Delhi, and the conference aimed to focus on the occupational safety and the health issues and challenges in the manufacturing, construction and the mining sector. Which one of the following week was observed from March 4th to 10th 2017? So let's say news. 2017 National Safety Week was observed from March 4th to 10th. Okay, to renewing the commitment of the employees and the general public to work safely throughout the year. Okay, National Safety Week, and it was observed by the National Safety Council since 1972, and the theme of this year is Keep Each Other Safe. This is the theme of the National Safety Week. So your answer is National Safety Week. India's largest municipal waste to power plant was inaugurated in which city? So let's see news. Venkatiah Naidu inaugurates India's largest municipal waste to power plant. Okay, so Venkatiah Naidu, and he's a CM of Andhra Pradesh, and the India's largest municipal waste to power plant was inaugurated in New Delhi. So your answer is A, New Delhi. Addressing the gathering, Naidu said that the one of the aim of the Swachh Bharat Mission is 100% management of municipal solid waste by 2019 in the country. So this is the aim of this Swachh Bharat Mission. They address it. Okay. Now let's see another question, that is exhibition Revolutionary Patriots 1905 to 1947 was inaugurated in which city? Another important question. So let's see the news. On the occasion of the 127th Foundation Day of the National Archives of India, an exhibition entitled Revolutionary Patriots, that is 1905 to 1947, was inaugurated in New Delhi by the N.K. Sinha and is the Secretary of the Ministry of Culture in the presence of Sri Raghuvendra Singh, Director General of the NAI and many dignitaries. Okay, so your answer is New Delhi. Okay, it was inaugurated in New Delhi. Assembly election result in five states. Another important question. The election commission finished vote counting for assembly election result in the five states including UP, Uttarakhand, Punjab, Goa and Manipur. So in the UP, total seat was 403, BJP won 312. Okay, and the chief, they made the chief minister of the Uttar Pradesh to Yogi Adityanath. Okay, Yogi Adityanath became the CM of the UP, and in Uttarakhand also BJP won 57 seats and a majority and of the out of the 70 seats, and they made CM Trivendra Singh Rawat. Okay, so you need to remember this also. Trivendra Singh Rawat became the CM of the Uttarakhand. And in Punjab, Congress won the majority by winning 77 seats out of 117, and Captain Amrinder Singh became the CM of the Punjab. And in Goa, Manohar Parikar resigned from the defense minister of India and became the CM of the Goa. Okay, and in the Manipur, you need to remember this, Manipur, the CM BJP occupied the majority in this both the states, okay, also, and proved their majority in both these states also. And in the Manipur, they made CM, the first BJP CM in the Manipur is N. Biren Singh, and he became the CM of Manipur. India's largest floating solar power plant is installed in which state? Another important question, friends, very important questions. Okay, so NTPC installs India's largest floating solar power plant in Kerala. So the this was installed in Kerala, and this is the 100 kWp floating solar generation plant, largest of its kind in India, was indigenously developed as a part of the Make in India initiative. Okay, and if we talk about the floating solar, largest floating solar power plant, then it will be in Kerala. If we talk about the largest solar power plant, then it will be in Tamil Nadu. Okay, you need to remember this. And the name of the largest solar power plant is the Kamuthi solar power plant. It is in Tamil Nadu and it is of 648 megawatt. Who has been appointed as the Chief Justice of the Madhya Pradesh High Court? So President appoints new Chief Justice in MP, Patna, Kerala, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand High Courts. Okay, so there are lot of appointments from the judiciary, and there are different Chief Justices which are placed in the MP, Patna, Kerala, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand and Jharkhand High Courts. Okay, so let's see one by one. Chhattisgarh High Court, Chief Justice of the Chhattisgarh High Court was appointed as Bhaskaran Nair Radhakrishnan. Okay, Kerala High Court, Justice Nana Niti Prasad Singh. Madhya Pradesh, Justice Hemant Gupta. Patna High Court, Justice Rajendra Menon. And Jharkhand High Court, Pradeep Kumar Mohanty. So these are the Chief Justices which are appointed by the President to the different High Courts. Okay, and your answer is Hemant Gupta. The Chief Justice of the Madhya Pradesh High Court is Hemant Gupta. Which railway region has launched a rail ambulance? So let's see the news. The Central Railway introduced a fully air-conditioned rail ambulance at Lonavala. The train painted in red and white will be stationed at the Kalyan and initially help railway employees and their families on the Central Railways. Okay, and there are four coaches in this ambulance called Operation Theatre Cum Recovery Wins. So your answer is Central Railways. So your B is your answer. Introduces rail ambulance. Which is the best Indian city to live in according to the Mercer Index? So let's see the news. Hyderabad, best Indian city in living standards. Okay, according to the Mercer surveys. And both Hyderabad and Pune ranked higher for quality of living than the country's traditional business centers like Mumbai and New Delhi, which has been ranked at 154 and 161. Okay, and the Hyderabad topped in list with having 144 points in this year. Okay, previously he had 139. So your answer is Hyderabad. Hyderabad and Pune are the best city in India to live in according to the Mercer Index. So let's see another question. Which state has launched a rupees 10 crore fund for women entrepreneurs? So another important question. So let's see the news first. The Karnataka government has launched a rupees 10 crore fund for women entrepreneurs through which the Department of Information Technology, Biotechnology and Science and Technology can sanction up to rupees 50 lakh for any woman innovator looking for the fund for proof of concept, validation, certification and for the other purposes such as the cover cost in manufacturing pilot devices. Okay, so if a woman from the Karnataka looking forward for a funding and if she has an innovative idea, then they can approach to the Karnataka government and she will get up to the rupees 10 crore loan from the Karnataka government. So your answer is B, that is Karnataka. Karnataka government sanctioned launched a 10 crore fund for women entrepreneurs. Which state has launched KCR kit scheme for pregnant women? So another important question. Telangana launches rupees 605 crore KCR kit scheme for pregnant women. So focusing on the women welfare and a newborn, Telangana Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao has come out with an innovative scheme, KCR kit, and consists of 16 essential things needed for a newborn and will be useful for up to the 3 months. Okay, and so your answer is Telangana. Telangana state has launched KCR kit scheme for pregnant women. Now let's see the trade and banking news. Which bank has launched work from home facility for employees? Another important question. So SBI launches work from home facility for employees. Country's largest lender, State Bank of India, has launched a new facility to enable its employees to work from home. Okay, so your answer is SBI. And the board of the bank has recently approved the work from home policy to enable its employee to work from home by using mobile devices to address any urgent requirement they may have that prevent their traveling to work. Which bank will offer payment related solutions to Udaipur, Nasik and Puducherry? Another important question. So Yes Bank bullish on smart cities signs up to 3 projects. So mid-sized private sector lender, that is Yes Bank, is looking at the smart cities initiative as a lucrative business opportunity and has signed 3 projects to offer payment related solutions, a senior officer said. And they tied up with the Udaipur, Nasik and the Puducherry for introducing various solutions for the smart city initiatives. Okay, so your answer is Yes Bank. Which bank has registered most number of fraud cases during April-December period of 2016? So ICICI Bank, SBI, Standard Chartered, top bank fraud list according to the RBI. ICICI Bank topped the list of bank that witnesses most number of frauds during the April to the December period of 2016, with state-owned SBI taking the second spot, RBI said. So your answer is ICICI Bank. Which country now is the biggest banking system in the world? Another important question. So China banking system overtake Eurozone to become the biggest in the world. Okay, so three of the world fourth largest bank by assets are now Chinese and they became the biggest in the world. Okay, biggest in the world in the banking system. So your answer is China. Capital of China is Beijing, currency is Yuan Renminbi, President is Jinping and Prime Minister is Li Keqiang. Milk to Money M2M program was launched by which bank in 2010? So HDFC Bank digitized over 1200 dairy cooperatives across India. So this is a private sector lender. HDFC Bank has digitized payment at the over 1200 dairy cooperatives in the country. Okay, this is also important that you need to remember. And the headquarter of this bank is in Mumbai. HDFC Bank, the headquarter is in Mumbai. You also need to remember this. Another important information that you need to remember. Okay, you need to remember the headquarters of the different bank friends because this is important. And let's see another question. The answer of the previous is HDFC. What is the new limit of NBFC cash loan against gold? So NBFC cash loan against gold restrict to rupees 25,000. So RBI has sharply brought down the threshold above which non-banking financial companies can disburse loan against gold only by cheque. And the central bank said with immediate effect, such loans amounting rupees 25,000 above can be disbursed only by cheque as against the earlier threshold of 1 lakh and above. Okay, so your answer is 25,000. Which bank has signed USD 274 million agreement with the German Development Bank KfW? So SBI German Development Bank KfW signed USD 274 million agreement. Okay, and they will provide facility to finance affordable housing segment in the country. State Bank of India has signed an agreement with the German Development Bank. Okay, and with this focus on housing loans for economically weaker section and lower income group households, the facility is designed to complement the government flagship affordable housing program, the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. Okay, so they will provide a facility in the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana to purchase a house for the affordable housing scheme, and they tied up with the German Development Bank. So your answer is SBI. SBI has signed rupees 274 million agreement with the German Development Bank, KFW. So another question, which bank has launched artificial intelligence driven chatbot EWA? So let's see news. HDFC Bank launches artificial intelligence driven chatbot EVA. Okay, so what is the EVA? That is electronic virtual assistant. It is an artificial intelligence driven chatbot for consumer services. And EVA is India's first AI based banking chatbot and can answer millions of customers' inquiries across multiple channels instantaneously. So your answer is HDFC. Okay, HDFC Bank launched this artificial intelligence driven chatbot, that is EVA, that is electronic virtual assistant. Let's see another question. Which is the India's cricket new sponsor? Very important question. BCCI appointed as a new sponsor of Indian cricket team. Okay, and who is the new sponsor of the Indian cricket team? So let's see the news. BCCI confirms Oppo as Indian cricket team new sponsor. Another very important question, friends, you need to remember. Okay, and so your answer is D, that is Oppo. The Board of Cricket Control in India has confirmed Oppo as its new sponsor. Oppo will replace Star on India's jersey after the latter contract ran out. The new deal was signed of rupees 1079 crore, which is 5 times more than the previous deal. Okay, so it is 5 times more than the previous deal, which was done with the Star India. Let's see another question. Which solar plant will receive a loan from World Bank? Another important question. Upcoming Rewa solar plant to receive loan from the World Bank. So the World Bank has agreed to provide loan to develop internal transmission agreement of the upcoming Rewa Ultra Mega Solar project in Madhya Pradesh. Okay, it will provide 25% of the loan amount under its clean technology fund, where the money will be provided at an interest rate of about only 0.25%. So the World Bank provided loan to the Rewa solar power plant. Okay, solar plant, and it is in Madhya Pradesh. This is the very important, that Rewa solar power plant is in Madhya Pradesh, that you need to remember. It is very important, guys. Which bank has won official language policy award for 2015 and 16? So Central Bank of India get official language policy award. So, and this award is the first prize in the implementation of the official language policy in the western region of the year 15 and 16. Okay, the Central Bank of India, some more information about the CBI, that is Central Bank of India, headquarters in Mumbai. It was founded on 21st December 1911. Chairperson is Rajiv Rishi and tagline is the central to you since 1911. Okay, so your answer is Central Bank of India has won official language policy award for 15 and 16. Now let's see some appointments question. D. Bala Venkatesh Verma has been appointed as the ambassador of India too. So the D. Bala Verma has been concurrently accredited as the next ambassador of India to the principality of the Andorra, the residence in the Madrid. Okay, so, and he is presently working as the ambassador of India to the Kingdom of Spain, and he is concurrently made an ambassador to the Andorra also. Andorra. Okay, so your answer is C, Andorra. And the capital of the Andorra is Andorra La Vella. Currency is Euro and Prime Minister is Antoni Marti. Who has been elected as a European Council President? Another very important question. So Donald Tusk re-elected as a European Council President, and he is re-elected as a EU, that is European Council President. Okay, and this is his second term of 2.5 years from 1st June 17 to 2019. Okay, so your answer is Donald Tusk has been elected as a European Council President. Who has been elected as a new mayor of Mumbai? Another very important question. Shiv Sena Vishwanath Mahadeshwar is new Mumbai mayor. Okay, so your answer is Vishwanath Mahadeshwar. Who is the official ambassador of ICC Women World Cup 2017? Another important question. So Sachin Tendulkar announced official ambassador by ICC. Okay, of the Women World Cup 2017. And it will be going to start in England. So this is another important information. First is the ambassador, second is the year, third is the place. These are the three things that you need to remember. And your answer is Sachin Tendulkar. Who has been appointed as a chairperson of Central Water Commission? So let's say news, Narendra Kumar takes over as chairperson of the Central Water Commission. So, and he's a officer of the Central Water Engineering Service. He's of IES 1979 batch, has assumed the charge of chairman, Central Water Commission. So your answer is Narendra Kumar. Manjeev Singh Puri has been appointed as the India's next envoy to which country? So Manjeev Singh Puri has been appointed as the new Indian envoy to Nepal. So your answer is Nepal. And presently is the ambassador of India to Belgium. Okay. Who has been appointed as a deputy governor in the RBI recently? Another important question. So BP Kanango was appointed as a deputy governor in the RBI for 3 years. So your answer is Kanango. BP Kanango. Who has been appointed as a brand ambassador of Chinese smartphone maker? That is OnePlus. So Chinese smartphone maker OnePlus has roped in Bollywood veteran Amitabh Bachchan as a new brand ambassador for India. Okay. So your answer is Amitabh Bachchan. Who is holding the additional charge of the Defence Ministry after the resignation of the Manohar Parikar? So Manohar Parikar became the CM of the Goa and Arun Jaitley get additional charge of Defence Ministry. So your answer is Arun Jaitley. Who is the new Chief Minister of Goa? Another very important question. As I said earlier, Manohar Parikar, who resigned from the Defence Ministry, is the new CM of Goa. Which bank has appointed Mark Tucker as a new chairman? So HSBC appoints Mark Tucker as a new chairman, and the headquarter of the HSBC is in London, UK, and it is a British bank and is the world's 7th largest bank by total assets also. Okay, and so your answer is HSBC. D is your answer. Who has been elected as the chairman of the KPMG International? So what is this KPMG? First of all, you need to understand this. Okay, it is a professional service company and one of the big four auditor along with the Deloitte, EY and PwC, and its headquarter is in Amsterdam. Okay, and what is the full form of KPMG? KPMG is Clement Peat Mawink, okay, Godeller. This is the full form of the KPMG. That you don't need to remember the full form of this. Okay, only to remember is the chairperson of the KPMG International is Bill Thomas. Now let's see the awards question. Which airport has the best service quality in 5 to 15 million passenger per annum category? So Hyderabad Delhi Airport ranked high in the service quality, and Delhi International Airport and the Hyderabad International Airport, both managed by GMR led consortium, has secured a top ranking in the airport service quality by the Airport Council International. Okay, and Delhi, that is Indira Gandhi International Airport, has become the world number 2 airport in the over 50 million passengers per annum category. Okay, so your answer is Hyderabad Airport. Which one of the following has won the Best Actress Award at the International Film Festival and the Award of Australia? So the Aishwarya Rai Bachchan win Best Actress Award at IFFAA. Okay, and the award was given because of the movie The Sarabjit, which is directed by the Umang Kumar. And she plays the role of her sister. Okay, and for that she won the award. And so your answer is Aishwarya Rai Bachchan. Aishwarya Rai Bachchan won this award. Who has been awarded with the Howard Foundation Artist of the Year Award? Another important question, friends. Okay, so Viola Davis named Howard Foundation Artist of the Year Award. Another important question, and you need to, and your answer is C, that is, okay, Viola Davis. And she's the actress award winner, and New Zealand native Viola Davis has named as the 2017 Howard Foundation Artist of the Year Award. Who has been honored with the 26th Saraswati Samman 2017? Another very important question. And Konkani author, that is Mahabaleshwar Sale, gets Saraswati Samman. Okay, this is very important question. 26th Saraswati Samman 2016. Okay, and for his novel, Hawthorn is the name of it. And he is a very famous, eminent Konkani writer, Mahabaleshwar Sale. So your answer is E, Mahabaleshwar Sale. Who has been awarded with the honorary degree of the Doctor of Science by the Maharashtra Animal and the Fishery Science University? So Bhagwat conferred honorary degree of the Doctor of Science, and who is the Bhagwat? He is a RSS chief, that is Mohan Bhagwat, was conferred honorary degree of the Doctor of Science by the city based Maharashtra Animal and the Fishery Science University. So your answer is Mohan Bhagwat. Zee Cine Awards 2017 winners announced, and the best film award was given to The Pink. Okay, you only need to remember the three things. That is the best film, best actor, female and best male actor. Okay, male actor was given to Amitabh Bachchan for The Pink. Female actor is Alia Bhatt for The Urta Punjab. Thai model wins transgender beauty pageant, and very important question, and the name of the person is Thailand's own Jarachia. Okay, you can remember this name. Jarachia won the Thai model wins transgender beauty contest. Now let's see the sports question. Santosh Trophy is related to which sports? Very important question, friends. Santosh Trophy started in Goa and it is a football tournament, and Goa will face Meghalaya in the opener of a Group A league, which match of the 71 Santosh Trophy at the SAG Athletic Stadium in Goa. Okay, and this Santosh Trophy was started in 1941, and it is very important championship of the football. Okay, and the mostly this tournament was won by West Bengal, and the current champion is the services. So your answer is football. Who has won men's singles title of All England Badminton Championship 2017? So men's singles title, we ask about the men's single title. So this award was won by Malaysian Lee Chong Wee. Okay, Malaysian Lee. So your answer is B. Okay, you only need to remember this single name. Apart from it, you don't need to remember anything. Okay, and it is the world oldest badminton championship, which was annually held in England. And it was started in 1899. The first tournament was held in 1899. Commonwealth Games, Durban, South Africa will not host games in 2022. So Commonwealth Games will no longer be held in Durban, South Africa. Okay, and what is this Commonwealth Games? It is a game which is played by all the Commonwealth of Nations. Okay, and the first this event was held in 1930. With the exception of the 1942 and 1946, this event was not able to be conducted at that time because of the World War II, and this event will take place at every 4 years. Okay, maximum in India, this tournament was held in 2010. Okay, 2010. At that time, 71 nations participated, and there are few nations apart from 52 nations of the Commonwealth of Nations. They came to participate in this by their own flag. And the top placed team at 2010 Commonwealth of Nations was Australia. Who has won Indian Open Golf title 2017? So SSP Chaurasia defends Indian Open title. Another very important question. Chaurasia, SSP Chaurasia. And he became the first Indian to defend a European Tour title. So let's see some death questions. Rene Parvel has passed away recently. He was a former president of which country? So he is a Haiti president. Okay, Rene Parvel, he died at the age of 74. So your answer is Haiti. Haiti, the capital of the Haiti is Port, currency is the Gourdi, and president is a Jovenel Moïse. Arvind Padmanabhan has passed away recently. Who he was? So veteran journalist Arvind Padmanabhan passed away, and he was a journalist. Okay, this is the only thing that you need to remember. George A. Ola has passed away recently. Who he was? And he was a Nobel winner. Okay, chemistry Nobel winner. So your answer is chemist. He was a chemist, great chemist, who won Nobel Prize in chemistry and paved the way for more effective oil refining and way of producing less polluting forms of gasoline. So friends, these are the important content from our second week of the March. I hope you will like it and will subscribe us. So friends, thank you and all the best.